हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम डॉक्टर अशोक येवले, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, KTHM कॉलेज, नासिक. इन अ टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन टॉपिक ऑफ चैप्टर किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा. द टॉपिक इज फीडिंग, डाइजेशन एंड एक्सक्रीशन इन पैरामीशियम. सो एट ए ग्लांस वील सी टॉपिक such as feeding in paramecium, second digestion in paramecium, and third excretion in paramecium. So let us start with feeding mechanism in paramecium. So feeding means how the paramecium takes food inside the body, and that is called as feeding. So in case of paramecium, we can see a very peculiar phenomenon of feeding, because paramecium is a microorganism. The body surrounds with a hair like organ called as cilia. So with the help of these cilia, they can feed food inside the body. Mostly the paramecium food includes bacteria, unicellular plants, and a small bits of animals and vegetable. Then paramecium with the help of cilia swims to the place where it can get its food, while it does not move at the time of feeding. So whenever feeding takes place, it remains stagnant, but remains of the time it swims into the place where it can get food. Food is ingested with the help of cytostome lying at the bottom of the buccal cavity. This diagram showing how the food takes place inside the body means the feeding in paramecium. See, the surrounding of the paramecium, there are a food material, and the food material which is present in the water. So due to water current, food particle moves or aggregated at the base of mouth of paramecium, that is cytostome. And at first, the cilia of oral groove moves very fast, so that drives the current of water with food particle towards vestibule. Second, the ciliary tract of vestibule direct the food particle into the buccal cavity. Then large food materials are rejected, whereas only smaller food particle and selected, it is ingested through the cytostome to cytopharynx. Means only a minute food particles enters into the body, while larger food particles are rejected from the body. The food gradually collect at the bottom of cytopharynx into the membranous vesicle, which is later released off as a food. So whenever the food particle is present just outside the body, so with the help of these pellicles, they can ingest the food particle in the body. That process is called as phagocytosis. Then the second topic, that is what type of digestion occurs in paramecium. So in the beginning we have seen how the feeding takes place, and after the feeding, second step is digestion. Digestion is a physiological process in which the complex food convert into simple food to get an energy rich molecule, that is ATP. So in case of protozoan, parasite, paramecium or amoeba, the intracellular digestion takes place. Intracellular digestion means what? The complete digestion takes place in a cell, so called as intracellular digestion. As I said, paramecium is a single cell animal, so whenever food enters in the cytoplasm of a cell, whole procedure of digestion is takes place in a cytoplasm, so called as intracellular digestion. So protozoan uses the pseudopodia or cilia for capturing food, processes called as phagocytosis. In case of paramecium, there is a cilia surrounding over the body which is useful for capturing food, while in case of amoeba, the finger like projections called as pseudopodia. So with the help of this pseudopodia, amoeba capture the food, while paramecium captures the food with the help of cilia, and the capturing food and take the food inside the body called as phagocytosis. Paramecium uses cilia in the oral groove to bring food into the mouth, that is cytostome, which goes into the cytopharynx. Then digestion in paramecium. Each food vacuole consists of food particles and it undergoes circulation in a definite path of cytoplasm of a cell called as cyclosis. In case of paramecium cytoplasm, whenever food entered in the cytoplasm, that food revolve periphery of the cytoplasm in a cell of paramecium called as cyclosis. The paramecium digestion takes place with the help of certain enzymes secreted in protoplasm. So whenever the certain enzymes are secreted into the body of paramecium, it is to be digested the complex food into simple food. The contents of vacuole first become acidic and then it become alkaline. So due to the action of acid, the food is digested into the cytoplasm. So acidic food convert into alkaline form. During digestion, proteins are converted into amino acid and carbohydrates convert into soluble sugar and glycogen into the cytoplasms. So the amino acids and soluble sugar and glycogen are the simple form of food, while proteins and carbohydrates are the complex food which inhale the paramecium outside the body. Finally, these complex food convert into simple form. So undigested food material are eliminated from the body through anal pore called as cytoproct, which is situated on the ventral surface of pellicle. So in this way, the digestion in paramecium takes place. This diagram shows a digestive system of paramecium. So with the help of vestibule and cilia, paramecium intake food material into the body, and a food material enter into the cytoplasm called as cytostome. So this cytostome entered the food material into the cytoplasm. Simultaneously, the circular action of cytoplasm, the food material revolve in a circular manner in cytoplasm. The process is called as cyclosis. And whenever food entered into the cytoplasm, suddenly the protoplasm secretes certain enzymes, and with the help of these enzymes, the food material digests into simple form. And after digestion, the undigested food material eliminate from the body through called as cytopy. So complete digestion in paramecium takes place in different form. In general, in paramecium, holozoic type of nutrition takes place. In holozoic type of nutrition means the digestion occurs in 5 stages. That is ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion. So intake of food is called as ingestion. Conversion of complex food into simple form called as digestion. Then absorption of essential nutrients into the body called as absorption, while the absorbed nutrients stored in the form of food vacuoles for generating energy called as assimilation, and undigested food material eliminate from the body called as ejection. So in case of paramecium, engulf food by use of cilia. Food is ingested by cilia through oral groove into gullet in the form of food vacuole, that is called as ingestion. Second, the intracellular digestion is there, means the complete digestion of complex food like proteins and carbohydrate into simple form, that is amino acid and glucose and glycogen. Absorption, digestion of food occurs in food vacuole by the process of cyclosis. Then assimilation, absorb nutrients, is stored and utilized later for synthesis of energy, that is generation of ATP molecule, energy rich molecule. Then ejection, the undigested food material eliminate through the anal pore called as cytopene. So in this way, ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and ejection, these five steps occur in intracellular digestion of paramecium, so it is called as holozoic type of nutrition also. This way we have seen the second physiological process, that is digestion in paramecium. Now we turn to third point of this presentation, that is excretion in paramecium. So what is excretion? Excretion is nothing but elimination of nitrogenous waste product from the body called as excretion. Excretion in paramecium is carried out by contractile vacuole. In a cytoplasm of paramecium, there is a presence of food vacuole as well as contractile vacuole. Food vacuole play their role in digestive system, while contractile vacuole play their role in excretion or excretory system in paramecium. In case of paramecium, two contractile vacuoles are there. One is present at the anterior end, while another is present at posterior end. Each contractile vacuole has a central bladder and six radiating canals. The structure of contractile vacuoles appears like a star. So as I said, there is a central bladder, and just the periphery of the bladder there are six radiating canals. And the main function of the contractile vacuole is osmoregulation, that is maintaining water and salt balance in the cytoplasm. See, this diagram shows a structure of contractile vacuole. At the center there is a bladder, and periphery of the bladder there are six radiating canals. So this star-like blue structure called as contractile vacuole, and the main function of contractile vacuole is osmoregulation, means maintaining water and salt balance into the protoplasm. See, whenever the food and water is present in the bladder of contractile vacuole, it remains bulge, pores opens and vacuole contract. So simultaneously the contraction and relaxation of bladder, there is a removal of water into the cytoplasm. So contraction of the vacuole expel out water from the cell, and the contractile vacuole become empty. Again, the radial canal takes water from the surrounding cytoplasm and it become swell. So water moves from radiating canal to the vacuole. So simultaneously the contractile vacuole get contracts and relax, and these contraction and relaxation of contractile vacuole expel water into the cytoplasm as well as to collect the water from the cytoplasm. So this activity of contractile vacuole maintain the water and salt balance into the cytoplasm. Then we'll discuss in detail excretion in paramecium. Excretion is a process of elimination of nitrogenous substances from the body. The undigested matter of food vacuoles are excreted through cytopic it is nothing but anal pore of paramecium. Waste product include urea and uric acid and other nitrogenous waste compound diffuse of the body through a general body surface. Means the pellicle, which is the outer covering of paramecium, and it is responsible for the elimination of nitrogenous waste product. So there is a presence of a single pore called as anal pore, or we can say cytopique. So crystal present in the body are excretory product, that is undigested food material, which get dissolved and are eliminated with the fluid of contractile vacuoles. The contractile vacuoles help in regulating the osmosis, and thus they help in the process of osmoregulation. The main function of contractile vacuole are osmoregulation, that is maintaining water and salt balance. The concentration of cytoplasm is higher than that of the surrounding water, and this result endosmosis, means enters the water into the cytoplasm. So water diffused through a semi-permeable membrane, that is pellicle, outer covering of paramecium. So excess water is collected and expelled out from the body by two contractile vacuoles, which is present at the anterior and posterior end of the paramecium body. So the radiating canal of contractile vacuole collect the water into their ampulla, and when the ampulla is filled up, water is discharged into the contractile vacuole. So the collection of water as well as discharge of water from the body into the cytoplasm, pellicle, so the maintaining osmoregulation by diffusion process, the vacuole get expand by collecting water, grown up maximum size, and it contracts the expelled water outside through a pore in the pellicle. So in this way, the contractile vacuole plays an important role, that is osmoregulation by the process of diffusion, and in case of cytoplasm of paramecium, maintaining osmoregulation process, while the elimination of nitrogenous waste product from the body through cytopic of a pellicle. So in this way, we have discussed three topics, that is feeding mechanism, digestion mechanism, and excretion mechanism in paramecium. So thanks for watching this presentation.